Thank you, Tech Solutions by Real-Time Expert.
Hello guys, welcome back to Venky Tech Solutions. This is Venky. In this video, we are going to learn about Oracle Data Types. There is an update about our channel. I have created one WhatsApp group for doubts and suggestions. So I will give you the link of that WhatsApp group in below of the video in description. By clicking through that link, you can able to join the group. Please join. If you get any doubts or suggestions, please post it there so that I will respond and right away. Data types. Oracle supports two types of data type. One is built-in data type, another one is user-defined data types. What is built-in data type? Is nothing but Oracle software, some inbuilt data types which is supported to the Oracle software. Those are called inbuilt data types. User-defined data types. Based on user requirement, user also can create the user-defined data type which is created by the user. That is called user-defined data types. Below are the data types are built-in data types: character, number, date time, large object, row ID, and long and raw data types. So these are the built-in data types. In this video, we will learn about character data type, number data type, date time data type. This is the first part one video of data types. I will upload in part video remaining three data types. You can also see that one to learn remaining data types. What is character data type? Character data type is used to store alphanumeric data. How Oracle server will treat as whatever you will give the data, that is character or not. See, whatever data or any data which is given in single quote while you are inserting, that Oracle server treated as character data type. These are the data types of character data types. We will see one by one. First, what is char data type? See, if I mention like this one bracket, that means not mandatory. Like this open parenthesis means, that means mandatory. Why? Because why I mention like this? See, if you see char, you will get to know like this not mandatory. So char data type is size is not mandatory. That is the reason I mention like this. See, the char data type is used to store character data to the table or whatever column you declared. It's fixed length data type. Maximum storage, maximum bytes it will allow to insert is 2000 bytes. So character data type is used to store character data. Size is not mandatory, and if it fixed length data type, and maximum storage 2000 bytes. What is nchar data type? Character data type is used to insert English language. If you want to insert any other language with English, you must use the nchar data type. These also work as same character data type. Next, varchar 2 data type. This is, see, I mentioned open parenthesis size. That means size is mandatory. It is also used to store character data type, and maximum size is 4000 bytes. You must specify the size because size is mandatory, and it's dynamic data type. So you will get doubt here, what is fixed length data type and what is dynamic data type. Fixed length data type is nothing but, I will explain you clearly. Here you can see first name I have declared as character 50, but I instead first name is column name, my column name. I have entered only Venky. So remaining here whatever, see this all for Venky is five letters, so 5 bytes. Remaining 45 bytes, the space is waste, right? Oracle server, what it will do in case of char, it will apply the blank pads like this, remaining space. But in case of varchar 2, how it will work? Varchar 2, here just I inserted the data, just Venky. Remaining space, whatever 45 is there, right? That remaining 45 bytes, it cannot apply the blank pads. It will send back to the Oracle server remaining space. So here we are consuming our space, so we are saving our space. That is the reason Oracle like that is the reason always recommended to use the varchar 2 based on the requirement. Okay, this is the difference, what is char, what is varchar 2, and what is dynamic data type and what is fixed length data type. Next, there is a varchar 2 subtype data type is there, that is varchar size. We can also use this data type. This is also same 4000 bytes, but once you declared as varchar size, Oracle server automatically converted as varchar 2 size. Next, n varchar 2 size. When varchar 2 size, this data type also same as varchar 2 data type. If you want to insert other than like any other language, you must use the n varchar 2 data type. This is the character data type. So here we will use most of the times is varchar 2 only. Rare case we will use char, but these two you must remember. Next, number data type. What is number data type? Number data type is used to store numeric data. How we have to declare is number precision scale. Here scale is not mandatory. That is the reason I mentioned is bracket. Okay. Remaining all we cannot use much, or we cannot use itself. Rare we will use, you just remember these things, but this number one is the number, this data type is important, but to give end-to-end knowledge I am explaining this all also. Here I already told number data type is used to store numeric data. Number data type is having precision and scale. Precision range it will allow 38 digits max. Scale is -84 to 127, it will allow. That means -83, 82, like that 0 and 2 till 127. Next, integer data type. If you declare integer data type as well, it will convert it as number as 38 digits. Next, float data type P. Float data type is subtype of number data type. The precision scale is 1 to 126. For example, if you want to insert more than 38 digits, by the time you have to use this float data type. 38, more than 38 numbers you are numeric data you are inserting, by the time recommended to use float data, because this range is 1 to 126. Example, you can see how you have to declare column name, float size, binary float and binary double. Binary float is nothing but, see, it will support only 32-bit software which is installed in your machine. You know, in last video I have explained what is 32-bit software, what is 42-bit software. If you install 42-bit software, these two will support float and double, binary float and binary double. If you install only 32-bit, only binary float support. It will support only 32-bit. See, this one is arithmetic calculations fast and reduce the storage requirement. Is the advantage of 2 is binary float. So we cannot use this much. We will use number data type and char and varchar 2. These three we will use much. Remaining all we cannot use. Rare we will use these remaining things. I will explain you end of the video practically how we have to declare these data types in Oracle. Next, datetime data types is used to store date and time values while you are inserting the data. So for example, we have to enter the data in single quote itself, but Oracle server will treat it as character, right? Whatever data will you if you mention in single quote, but when you enter the date here, Oracle server automatically convert as default date format, that is 2_date values. You just remember this is the function 2_date. We will learn about this in functions. Okay. Now data types is like time and date time stamp. This time stamp data types. Data type is used to store only date format. That format is DDMMYY. This is the, it cannot store the time like hours, minutes, seconds. To overcome this problem, Oracle introduced timestamp data type. This data type stores along with date time as well. See, hours, minutes, seconds, like this. So it will range it will allow you like this: January 1st 4712 before crisis to December 31st 9999 after Domino. So these words is difficult, you just remember BC and AD. So before century or else after decade, like that you just remember. So now I will show you how to declare in practically. I am just connecting as CCS SysDBA user. I will show you in another video how to create your own schema. See, just connected, create table, table name as student I am taking. Here you just remember that column names and data type how we have to declare. I will tell you like another video what is create, what is table, and what is column, what is row. These all these things I will explain you in another video. See, student ID is a number. This is the column name, student ID. Student ID is numeric data type. So I am declaring as number data type. Next, first name. While you are giving column name, you should not give the space in between the column name. So like this. See, this is the way you should not give space. So you just remember that one also. And one more thing, while you are declaring the columns and data types, you must give the comma separated columns. That is like Oracle software developer, so we have to follow that rules. Next, gender is I have declared as char. I did not giving in data type size. Next, comma, then I am giving as join date. Date I am giving. See, table is created. If you want to see description of table name, student. See, Oracle server automatically taken as carries 1 byte. We did not declare here, but it has taken 1 byte. Okay, size is not mandatory for this char data type, but if you did not declare as well, it will take automatically by default as 1 byte. See how we have declared column name and size. Based on the column name, we are declaring the data type. Here, student ID. ID is a numeric data. We are declaring as number data type. Varchar to type. Gender is like 1 byte. So we are not taking varchar to, because we are, if it is female, like if you are entering details as female, F we will give. If men, we will give M. Okay. This is the part 1 video. I will explain you remaining 3 data types in another video. You can see that video and you can learn remaining data types. So if you are watching my video on first time, please like and subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to get latest updates. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.